all existing research is flawed in some way. We talk about truth for now in science. So when we do literature reviews, what we are doing at the end of the day is trying to get closer to whatever that truth is going to be. When we are novices, we normally stop at the first step, which is to summarize the extant literature. So what is out there and what are different people saying about it? An omission sometimes can be a legitimate basis for trying to expand the knowledge or at least rethink how we are looking at certain phenomena. Try to understand the ways in which these authors might diverge, that they might contradict each other, that they might converge in ways that might be a cause for concern. I'm Dr. Noni Chi Extra. Follow me to find the joy in academic writing and discover your real potential. Happy writing.
And go.
The thing about scientific truths is that we talk about truth for now in science. And what it means is that we do conceive of a reality where there is a truth that is absolute, but we have limitations in terms of our ability to capture that truth or to measure it exactly. This might relate to the types of instruments that we're using. It could be related to the lenses through which we look at problems. There's also, of course, other schools of thought that are more inclined to believe that such an objective reality or objective truth does not exist, but it depends on the perspectives through which we look at those problems, the lenses through which we see the world and phenomenon. And therefore, that school of thought also means that we are not ideally looking to get closer to the truth, but we're looking to understand reality from those different perspectives. So when we do literature reviews, what we are doing at the end of the day is trying to get closer to whatever that truth is going to be. So in order to do that, one of the things that we accept upfront is that all existing research is flawed in some way. The people before us have put in some serious work to get us as close as we can to understanding the truth as it may exist, but they didn't get close enough, and we are on a quest to try to get closer. So when we are reviewing the literature, these are the four key things, in my view, that we tend to look for that help us to position our research in a way that also improves the quality of the knowledge. So the knowledge generation process is not necessarily to just add to the existing body of literature, but it is to improve the understanding in the existing body of the literature. So here are four things that you will typically look for when you do your literature review. When we are novices, we normally stop at the first step, which is to summarize the extant literature. So what is out there and what are different people saying about it? But a true literature review will go further in one of these four ways. Once you've summarized the literature, you're going to look for evidence of divergence of thought or conclusions. This divergence could be in the empirical observations that are made. It could be in the fundamental underlying assumptions that inform particular research streams. But we try to look at the different bits of literature from what we have reviewed and try to see the places where they don't exactly agree or they're going in different directions. The second thing we can look for is direct contradictions. So whereas divergence might mean that they are coming up with different things, but those things are not in direct tension, contradictions are things that are opposites. So one says that it is better that we go east on this particular phenomenon, and another says it's better that we go west. So these obvious contradictions then cause us to dig deeper. If we are talking about exactly the same phenomenon and we are using similar instruments, how come we are reaching such wildly different conclusions? A third thing to look for is convergence. So sometimes the literature is well aligned in certain respects, and sometimes this convergence can be a good sign. So it means that in general, we might be getting closer to the truth as we think it might be. But also sometimes this convergence or this consensus might point to a fundamental flaw in how an entire body of research has been thinking about a particular problem. So there can be issues where even though there is consensus in the literature, there could be certain issues fundamentally that are problematic that we need to question. And for you to be able to question such convergence, usually the only simple thing that you have to do is identify an exception. So if there are rules about how the world works, let's say, and we think they're established and we take them for granted, if you can identify a single instance where this rule doesn't apply, then you have found the reason to poke the literature to question whether this agreement is legitimate or whether fundamentally there's been an issue in how we've been thinking about a problem. Finally, you can look for omissions. So there can be certain things in the literature that you might expect to find, whether it's based on your experience or it's based on knowledge that you have extracted from other fields. But you look at a particular stream of literature and you find that they hardly address a particular thing. So these omissions, if we think that there's something significant, can be a reason to exploit and explore what could be happening and whether addressing this omission is going to take us someplace else. So as an example, one of my first ever research projects was trying to understand how host governments impact humanitarian logistics. And the omission for me was that even though government is the most mentioned word in humanitarian logistics literature, there's hardly any empirical research that helps us to understand the ways in which governments impact the logistics performance of international humanitarian organizations that tend to be the focus in this research stream. So an omission sometimes can be a legitimate basis for trying to expand the knowledge or at least rethink how we are looking at certain phenomena in a way that is going to lead to valuable knowledge. So the next time that you have to do a literature review, the first thing that you have to understand is that there is no perfect knowledge out there. Even the most established researchers are human beings who are limited in the ways in which they can conceive of or conceptualize the world. All you have to do in order to be able to identify a gap as part of the literature review process is to not just provide an overview of what these different scholars are saying, but try to understand the ways in which these authors might diverge, that they might contradict each other, that they might converge in ways that might be a cause for concern, and the ways also in which they might be omitting certain important things that can push the boundaries of knowledge. Hopefully, this is going to make your literature review process a bit more exciting. I'm Dr. Nonichi Extra. Follow me to find the joy in academic writing and discover your real potential. Happy writing.
And go. Oh.